Okay, so I'm picking it up from here, and I've been kind of musing on something right now, just to refresh our memories. We had this, I put these edges in, and I was correlating this middle layer here. So I got the middle layer in over here, and then the layer just below that I've got as well. And I kind of correlated that with these centers here. And you can see this layer below is just fine, but I ran into a problem because I was finding that as I was placing this layer up here, the centers weren't syncing with this. So I've got, I'm one opposite edge swap away from putting this in, but if I do that, I'm going to cause parity over here. I'm going to cause this to be flipped. So how did that happen? There's no way for me to apparently get out of this, and there shouldn't be that kind of parity with this. You can see that all these corners are where they need to be because they're lined up with this level. You can see that this center is good and this center is good, and I can take this center over here, move it across, and see that it matches up with this center over here at about the way that this matches up with this as well. So I seem to be in something of an impossible situation. Now, when looking at something like this, when I see an impossible situation, it means that there must be some kind of false equivalency, because it's not really a parity that I should be dealing with in an odd layer puzzle, because I didn't reduce it from an even layer to an odd layer. So there should be no confusion. So I'm thinking, is there another center that has to swap? So in other words, I can swap these two, but there must be another center that can swap with this. So I'm looking for maybe another center that looks like this. And that's where my dilemma is, because I have not found any such center. All of these center areas, these center stripes, are fairly unique in where they're supposed to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for other things that might not be in where they're supposed to be. And I've looked at all the different centers, and it's just not the case. But I do know that it's not supposed to be quite like this. What I'm going to do is I can see that this is up over here, and I'm going to see if I can't get these edges in and see if there's some clue to that. So what I'm going to do to permute these edges around, and I'm just sort of searching around here, is we'll go like R U RI U R 2 U RI. So the answer is here somewhere. I'm just kind of organizing things around. It's not there yet, so we'll do it again. R U. Okay, so here's something that's interesting. You can see this is correctly placed. This is correctly placed, this is correctly placed, this is upside down, and we're not supposed to get that with an odd layer puzzle. So when I see one piece that's upside down, this would appear to be a parity, but it just means that something else is upside down. Now, normally what happens in a situation like this is the way that you get this is if one of the middle edges had to be inverted. So maybe the key to this, and this is what this is showing me, that the way this puzzle is organized here isn't set up right. Something is inverted. Something is not quite where it's supposed to be. So what I'm going to do is look at this middle layer here, and there must be one piece that can turn upside down and still be exactly right. You know, still have a place, have equivalency. Well, not this one. If I turn this upside down, obviously it's not going to work. Not this either. Not this. This one? No, it's pretty specific, because then it'll be facing up, and now I'm back to here. So it's not that. That would be a nice, simple explanation, but it's not the correct one. None of these are upside down. So the question is, why can I not find the right edge swap without turning this upside down and having this upside down? So what that means is there must be an edge that's not correct. Something that can turn this, in which case another edge has to turn too. Because I can't just turn this around without turning something else. So I'm going to look a little closer here. And if I look really close here, actually over here, and I kind of was noticing this before, but although this is where it's supposed to be in conjunction with these guys, it doesn't appear to be lined up correctly. So here's my suspicion. This little piece here is upside down in conjunction with these guys. That would make sense, because if I just look at it as the middle, which is the point of reference, this is right side up, this is right side up, this is upside down, and this is upside down. If that's the case, then that means that these two, or these four pieces here, have to be swapped. So these guys have to be swapped. So that is a key problem with the solve of this, and might be a hint as to what's going on with this. And maybe this process is what's causing things to be messed up over here. The whole key is that I can't just accept the fact that this is put in correctly, because I'm not supposed to get this kind of parity. So this might be the key. So what I need to do is I need to go back into my reduction and reduce it again and swap these guys to turn around over here. That way two of these are upside down. So the way to do this, can you guess what I'm going to do? Well, the old faithful Red Bull algorithm. The Red Bull algorithm will provide exactly that function, to put this to here and this to here, to rotate these around. Now, having done these supercubes enough, I know that there's going to be a potential problem. To do the Red Bull algorithm, we'll swap these two, but there's going to be a price, because this will constitute, even though there's four pieces, these together, when they swap, constitutes as one swap. Something else is going to be swapped, and I believe it's going to be this center here. So I can Red Bull this, but to Red Bull this means I'm going to do something nasty to this center. So let's see what happens. Because at this point, I have no choice. I have to do this and see where we go. So we have a 2R. Let's take some concentration here. To B, to U, L. Two up, RI, don't want to get lost here. Two up, R, two up, two F, R, 2F, and finally LI, and hopefully I didn't get lost, but we have a 2B, and hopefully I didn't get lost, 2R. Okay, so let's take a look, make sure everything is fine. You can see this is now completely in fine. This actually lines up pretty well. This lines up pretty nicely over here. But as predicted, I did horrible things to the center. This whole piece here also got rotated. So that was the price to pay. To swap these two, this got rotated. So this is right side up, this is right side up, this is upside down, and now this is upside down. But here's what we've got. This is now also wrong. So this center stripe is upside down. So how can I use this? What can I do with this? Well, what I want to do is I'd like to cleanly move this back. The only way that that's going to cleanly move back is if I do another Red Bull algorithm with another center, with another edge rather. Well, certainly not this one. I actually finally got this in, not any of these. So my thinking is this. Why don't I take this edge over here, this whole edge set, move this up here, and then do the Red Bull algorithm again? If I do that, that'll get this back and cause a flipping of these two. I think that flipping of those two will then sync this center and this center together. It'll sync these layer centers with this layer center. Because remember, when I did my corner swaps, I ended up with this being placed correctly, which was bad because then I had a adjacent edge swap that is kind of orphaned. To do this means turning this upside down. So my suspicion is that was the problem all along. Because I had these two swapped incorrectly, this was destined to not come in correctly. So now what I've got to do is I've got to very cleanly do another Red Bull algorithm to swap that. So how am I going to do that? Well, all I have to do is deconstruct it and just go like this. I'm going to go like this, red bullet, and then just move it back down. The end result of that is this will be in, these will all be swapped, and then I just move it back down. I haven't really got these in place yet, so that doesn't matter, and then that should coordinate it. So that's just my theory, but the overall effect is swapping these will swap these. And then once I swap these again, it'll bring this layer here back into sync to get me out of that situation. So, with shaking hands, I move this into place, and we'll give it a try. I just can't lose track of what I'm doing because now I don't have a lot of signposts to tell me where I'm at. Let's very carefully do another Red Bull algorithm. So, here we go. All right, I'm getting nervous. Two R. Can't lose track here. 2R. Oop. If I knock something, I'll lose track. 2B, I think. 2U. And this thing here is the L. L. Two up, RI. Two up, R. Two up, two F. R, 2F, and here we go, LI, 2B, and 2R. And the whole thing about deconstructing and reconstructing is you should be able to construct it right back where you were. So, this is now placed back in. And all I got to do is place this down here. Okay, now we take a look. Now, as you can see, we still have this upside down and these right side up, but that's okay because now I take a look at where we've got here. The middle layer is still in, but you can see that this layer just below the middle layer, all these are in, but this isn't correct. And now I know that this one is the correct one to come down over here. In case I'm skittish about that and I want to make sure that every movement I do is the correct, I'm going to place this over here and just see if that still belongs to here. And see if this fixed the whole doggone thing. One, two. You can see that fits in here. So just checking my work. Bring this back and now let's try it again. Check our work here again. Is all these corners should be in. So these line up, this lines up, this lines up, and this lines up. So now it's a question of center placement. So which center is supposed to go where? That is a question. So now I know that the corner areas are fine. So let's see if we can reason this out. This is fairly, okay, so this is in over here. So I'm gonna kind of keep this to the side here. Where should this go? Well, my thinking is that this is long over here, so this probably comes to here. So I'm going to swap these two. So an adjacent corner swap. We see that this fits here very nicely. So this is in and this is in. We've got placement parity over here. Move this over here, and it's perfect because now I just have to move, I have to swap these centers, which will swap this back so you can see that parity was taken out. Again, not really parity in my book, just false equivocation leading to misplacement. So I'm going to swap these two, and that's what I was looking for. Before, swapping these two would have taken this out of alignment when it was already in alignment. Now it's out of alignment, it'll place it back. So you can see all these are now in. So that was just a matter of figuring that out. Now let's go take a look. If this were the 5x5 ghost, we'd be pretty much done. Just about done. But I'm going to move this in to see if we can find where things make sense, just for the sake of orientation, just to check our work. Okay, this belongs here, this comes over here. So now you can see these three layers work just fine. And these centers are just fine as well. So that squared that away. And that, believe it or not, is not the hard part. The real hard part, despite everything we've been through, is still yet to come. But what I'm going to do, even though the 5-layer version would have been done by now, because this is 7 layers, now we do the same thing and hope and pray that we have not reached the same issues with false equivocation, because now I'm going to work on these layers above and below. Okay, now that we have that bit of complexity done, now I move on to the next layers. Done these three, I'm going to move on to this. So I'm going to find the corner that goes into here. And let's see if it starts up here, if it belongs up, if it's in this layer here. So I'm going to, after positioning it, find myself back to movable mode. Got to get that little corner lined up. Once I do, it should move nicely. Okay, move this down here, and we see, does this fit? Sort of. Sure, let's give it a try. So I'm going to move this back here. And we'll go ahead and bring this down and see just how good a home it finds. Now hopefully I've gotten all the equivocation done, but we'll see. You never know. Anyway, so top to bottom here to our U, to our UI, and to our, and that fits real nice over there. So I'm going to continue to turn this around then. Now which one goes over here? How about this? It's kind of got a wedge look to it. This, yeah, we got something good here. So obviously this is not the hard part. We're getting to that, trust me. And it will blow your mind. Okay, so this will come down to here. To our U. To our UI 2R. So this is in, and I'm not held to this area since I've got all the placement issues out. Now what goes here? It's going to be something long, so I can kind of visualize a little bit more what it's supposed to be. And I'm wondering if it's this guy here. This, I think, finds a nice home over here. So I'm going to skip that. This is going to be a teeny tiny piece that fits between here and here. It might even be this piece or this piece. So let's see if anything immediately fits. Certainly not that. Let's see how this next one fits in with that. Because my hope is that not only will this place this one here, but it'll remove this so I can put this over here. If it indeed goes there. Check it out. Perfect. So we are now cruising. I think a lot of the early difficulties were done. To our U, to our UI. Boy, this thing gets slippery. And to our. So we're good. We've created placement parity all along these three layers, so we don't want to move it from here. However, I can now move this, and I'm not even going to check it out because I think this has to be it. So let's give it a try. To our you. To our UI. And to our. Aha! All too easy. There it is. So I've got these in. So now you can see this layer is now fine. Now to put this reciprocal layer in, we do the same thing. I'm going to line these up so that I can see where the corners go. Whoop. Now I don't want to be lulled into a false sense of security, even though it seems to be going pretty well. I could end up with having put something in wrong, and only now might it become apparent. So this belongs here, this doesn't belong here, and this doesn't belong here. So that those corners aren't in. So I'm going to keep heading around. Does this belong here? Well, if it does, still don't have all the corners in. Okay, how about this? This here. So, nope. How about this corner here? Where does this belong? Yeah, it's kind of hard to say. I mean, maybe it's lined up here. Maybe this is where it belongs. Aha, okay. So see this corner here and this here? Both of these are lined up, which tells me that these two are in. These two are fine. This goes to the left. To the left. Then I do a corner swap here to swap these two. So we now put this into moving position. Put this into off-center position so that I can swap these guys. This comes over here. This comes over here. And now we just plug it in. Plug and chug. So line it up to our U, to our UI, to our turn, and then the very bottom one turns, and then finish it up with line it up to our UI to our U and to our. Okay, now let's check our work. Put this back into center position here. And now let's see. Actually, this isn't right. There we go. And now let's see if all these corners fit and match. Okay? Good, 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 good. It's always nice when a plan comes together. So now let's put this back into ready position. Because now it's a matter of moving the centers in. And now I've got to wonder and worry if I have them in the right place. So what centers belong where? This doesn't belong here. Okay, so we have a contender over here. This belongs over here. So what belongs here? This guy? Possibly. This maybe matches with this. So let's flip-flop these two. Unless this center, yeah, it's gotta be. Okay. So I'm gonna flip-flop these two, do an adjacent edge swap. Move this in here. And I have to remember, I'm gonna put my thumb here so that I make sure I just move this layer over here and not get confused. To our U. To our U. To our, to you, to our, to you, to our. You, to 2R UI and 2R. I almost feel like I'm walking in the dark because I don't have really a lot to guide me except just the algorithm itself. Okay, so this does fit. So this centers in, this centers in. I've created placement, misplacement over here, so I gotta make sure that this stays where it's at whilst I try to move this. And now what I wanna do is swap these two, and that's it. So there won't be any parity with this. So we're gonna swap these two. And here we go. 2R U.2R to you, to our you, to our you are, and to our. Okay. So now this layer is in. So all these layers are good, and I don't have to check my work because now I can do these layers independently of each other. I don't have to worry about these guys here. So from top to bottom, I'm gonna put this one in first over here. So what belongs over here? Well, it's gonna be the same thing. I'm gonna try to put corners in. So here's the thing. I have a choice now. Basically what I did is I've taken this puzzle and reduced all my centers and edges. All of these centers are going to stay in association with each other throughout the rest of the solve, and now all these edges are pretty much reduced. They're all reduced because they're in the proper orientation with each other. So these belong together, so that they can be solved. So what I can do is I could just do a beginner's method and just start putting it in. So, in actuality, what I might do is just take the chance, keep these in the same association with each other, and go ahead and just solve the top and the bottom. As long as I don't take these edges out of alignment, keep them together, then I should be fine. Now, I'll have to go like this. Turn, turn. Turn. Okay, so this I know belongs over here. Am I going to be able to remember that, or should I just put that in right now? Well, let's keep going with this. This might be a mistake, but let's keep going with this. I think this probably belongs here. As you can see, that fits nicely over there. So I'm just going to move that in. So I'm just solving this like a 3x3 ghost right now, but I can't get too comfortable with this, because I might lose my perspective and forget which edges go with which. So I'll move this out of the way over here, turn. And like I say, like any reduced edges, I'm just gonna keep them together. Turn, turn. And turn. Now these centers should not be screwed up in conjunction with each other. So now I'm going to take this over here and move this to here, because I think this belongs over here. So move it out of the way. Now again, I think I'm kind of taking a little chance here on destroying my perspective, but turn, turn, and turn. Okay, good, 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 I think, yeah. Now this little guy belongs here, but I have to get it in the right orientation. Let me move this over here and orient this correctly. So what I appear to have here, yeah, is my first layer over here. Now I'm going to turn this upside down and place these where they're supposed to be. And aha, this is correct over here. So I got one here, and I'm just gonna do normal algorithms to bring this in. U R UI RI UI FI U, and you got this tiny piece swimming around in here, and F. Okay. Now we just keep going. Here, yeah, okay. Now I'm not so worried. So now I just do the other end. UI. LI. Can't lose track here. U. L. U. F. And UI and FI. Could it be that the end is in sight? Well, let's not celebrate yet, because the hard part is actually coming. Did you figure out what it is yet? Okay, so we have first, second, third, fourth, and fifth layer in. Now we just do this one. Now this is without parity, so I don't have to worry about that. Well, actually, I don't know which is upside down and right side up, so maybe I should do that first. Well, I know this is right side up. Is it? Yeah, I suppose. Still thinking this looks a little off here. I don't know why. But in any case, I can use this as a basis of comparison. So I think that this is probably upside down. So this is upside down. This is right side up. This is right side up, which means this is also probably upside down. So because of that, I'm going to do F R U R I UI FI. Okay. Well, right side up, right side up. The only problem that I have here now is I can tell this is right side up and this is right side up, but this one appears to be out. You can't have two in and you can't have three in and two out. Rather, you can't have three in and one out. So I gotta look a little closer and see what's going on here. Well, let's align the whole puzzle right now and see, just kind of see how it fits together. See if maybe I can see something. So you can see all of this is in. I just got this top part, but let's put in what we know should be correct. So this is all correct. We like this. We like this. We got this over here that has to be flipped. And I look at this and I think I'm in some trouble because this doesn't seem to fit. And I'm wondering if these have to be flipped or something or what, but I'm gonna say that maybe this has to go upside down. The only possible reasonable explanation is that these two are upside down and these two are right side up. So let's see what happens if I flip this one more time. I'll go ahead and line this up. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do the algorithm, because it belongs here, but it doesn't seem to fit. But let's give it a try. F are you are I UI and FI. Okay, so now let's try it again. See what happens. This is in, and let's assume or hope that it's right side up. Are you R I U R to you R I try it again R U R I U moment of truth R to you and R I and aha. So I thought it was right side up, but it turns out that this has equivalency of position, and now this fits a lot better. So now we see this is in the right place. What about this? Sort of, but no, this is not in the right place, nor is this, nor is this, which means there's no parities with that. So now we basically permute this around until this guy comes to here. So that's going to be, you ready? You guys ready for this? You are UI all the way here. LI U R I UI. L. Okay, this is in and it's oriented right. This is in and it's oriented right. These two, I can only assume, are in but just need to be oriented. And that's what I'm going to do. So this could be a puzzle solving move here. R I D I R D R I DI fits nicely. R D and move this over here. And a couple cycles of that should do it. R I DI R D R I D I R D. I think one more cycle now. R I D I R D R I D I looks good. R D. And now that we have all the layers assembled, let's go ahead and turn our 7-layer ghost cube into its solid position, turning here, here, and here. And as we can see, finally, we have ourselves a completely assembled and solved 7-layer, 7x7 ghost puzzle. And boy, am I excited. So there it is, finally solved. That which I had feared for so long, and that had taken me, I think even lost count in terms of how many days that lasted, but we see a perfectly square, nice and symmetric, seven layer ghost cube. So now that it's finished, at the journey's end, where does that leave us? After all the strategies have been thought out, after all the problems have been solved, after all the dilemmas have been reached to its conclusion, where we're left with now, returning the puzzle back to where it came from, putting it away back on the shelf, solved, that is the hardest part. Thank you for watching.